Good morning, students. Welcome to Maths class. Today we are going to continue AP, GP and AGP. What is AGP? Arithmetic or geometric progression. Now, take your exercise 5.2, 7th problem. And the question is, if A, B, C are in GP, what is given? ABC or GP condition is given. And if A power 1 by X equal to B power 1 by Y equal to C power 1 by Z. This is also given. Using this, prove that X, Y, Z are in arithmetic progression. So actually what is given? ABC is a geometric progression is given. And also one condition is given, A power 1 by X equal to B power 1 by X equal to C power 1 by Z. Using these two conditions, what we are going to do? Prove that X, Y, Z are in AP. Okay, so whatever is given, that we can take it as given that A, B, C are in GP. And also what is given? A power 1 by X equal to B power 1 by Y equal to C power 1 by Z. What we want to prove? X, Y, Z are AP. Is that question clear? Let's see the solution. Now, here the condition, this condition we can take it as some constant K. So here you can write this as A power 1 by X equal to B power 1 by Y equal to C power 1 by Z, which is equal to K. Okay, when power is in left hand side, right? So when power goes to right hand side, how it will change? It will take a reciprocal. So this A power 1 by X equal to K. Okay, that we can write A equal to, when 1 by X goes to your right side, it will become K power X. Similarly, B power 1 by Y equal to K implies B equal to K power Y. C power 1 by Z equal to K implies C equal to K power Z. Now we got the value A, B, C. Correct? And what is given about ABC? ABC are in GP. Okay, so it is given that ABC are in GP. What is GP condition? Second term divide first term, which is equal to third term divide second term. Correct? So whatever the condition is there, that we are taking. So what is the condition? Second term divide first term, which is equal to third term divide second term. Is that okay? Now take B to that side, A to right hand side, which implies we can write it this as B square equal to AC. Is that clear? Okay, now we got the condition B square is equal to AC. Now we have the value A. We know ABC, right? That you can substitute here. What is your A value, B value, K power Y? So we can write it this as K power Y the whole square, which is equal to A value is K power X, C value is K power Z. Correct? Okay, now again we can write this as K power Y the whole square. We can write it as 2Y, which is equal to, now base are equal. If base are equal, we can add the power, correct? So we can write it this as K power X plus Z, right? Now again look at here, left hand side, right hand side, base are equal. So again if base are equal, you can equate the left hand side and right hand side. That is 2y equal to X plus Z. Correct? Now this 2y we can write it as Y plus Y, which is equal to X plus Z. Now take 1x to left hand side, 1y to right hand side. So this will become Y minus X which is equal to z minus y. Now tell me, what is AB condition? AB condition is second term minus first term, which is equal to third term minus second term. Now look at this one. X, Y, Z are in AB na. It should satisfy the condition y minus x. Look at here, y minus x equal to z minus y. Y minus x, see, y minus x equal to z minus y, we got it, right? Therefore, we can say x, y, z are in arithmetic progression. Next, eighth question. And the question, the AM of two numbers exceeds their GM by 10 and HM by 16. Find the numbers. What is AM? Arithmetic mean. What is GM? Geometric mean. What is HM? Harmonic mean. Correct? Okay. So what is given here? The arithmetic mean of two numbers exceeds their GM by 10. So we are taking some two numbers. That two numbers of AB will exceed their GB by 10 and HM by 16. Using this condition, we are going to find the numbers. Okay, ma? Let's see the solution. Solution. Okay, two numbers are there. So we can take, let the numbers be A and B. Two numbers we are taking. So let the numbers be A and B. And what is AM condition? A equal to A plus B by 2. What is GM condition? GM is root of AB. What is HM condition? 2AB by A plus B. This is, we know, A by, this is A form, AM formula, GM formula, HM formula. Now, what is given? It is given that AM exceed their GM by 10. So that we can take it as A minus G equal to 10. And also by HM, 16. So A minus H equal to 16. Okay, so A minus G equal to 10, A minus H equal to 16. Now, this is a formula. We know that G square is equal to A H. That is, geometric mean square is equal to arithmetic mean into harmonic mean. Okay, so this A, G square equal to A H is a formula. Now, instead of G, we can take it, okay, from this one, G, we can take it as A minus 10. Similarly, from this, H can be taken as A minus 16. Now, substitute those values here. G value is A minus 10 the whole square equal to A as it is, H value A minus 16. Why we are changing like this? We have to change all the variable in terms of one variable. So that's why we are changing G and H. A remains same. Now we are going to simplify this. What is A minus B the whole square? A square plus B square plus 2AB. Correct? So we can write it this as A square minus 2AB. So 2 into 10, 20. 20A plus 100, which is equal to A square, multiplying this to A square minus 16A. Is that clear? Now, again simplify this one. This A square will get cancelled. A square will get cancelled. And again, taking 20 to that side, you will get plus 20A. So, you will get 100 equal to 4A. That is A equal to 25. So what we got? A value as 25. Now we know the formula A equal to A plus B by 2, that we can use. So A equal to A plus B by 2. implies your A value is 25. That is equal to A plus B by 2. Taking 2 to that side, you will get A plus B equal to 50. What you got? A plus B equal to 50. Next we can take G equal to, what is G here? A minus 10. So A minus 10, which implies A value we know, 25. So 25 minus 10, which is equal to 15. So what is your G value? 15. Right? Now, if you know your G value, you can use the formula G equal to root of AB. Okay? So G equal to root of AB. That is 15. What is G value? 15, which is equal to root of AB. Then squaring on both sides, 15 square is 225, which is equal to AB. Again, this you can write it as B equal to 225 by A. Now, you can take it, this as equation number 1. B equal to 225 by A. No, that you can substitute in equation 1. Is that okay? Now, what is your equation 1? A plus B equal to 50. That is A plus, what is your B value? 225 by A equal to 50. Is that right? Now, taking LCM, you will get A square plus 225, and taking A to that side, you will get 50A. 50A. Taking everything to one side, you will get A square minus 50A plus 225 equal to 0. Is that clear? Okay, now we have to use tree method to get the value of, to get the factor. So what is, we have to do 225 and we have to get minus 50. So what are the two numbers? Minus 45 into 5. See, now 45 into 5 is 225, and minus 45 plus minus 5 is minus 50. Correct? Okay. So we can write it this as, factor as A minus 45, A minus 45 into A minus 5 equal to 0 implies, what is your A value? 5 comma 45. So we got two A values, 5 and 45. So using these two A values, you have to find out the B value. Substitute that A value in B. So B equal to 225 by A. No, substituting first A equal to 5, you will get B equal to 225 by 5, which is equal to 45. Similarly, if you substitute A equal to 45, then B equal to 225 by 45, which is equal to 5. Anyhow, what are the two numbers? 5 and 45. So this is your final answer. Next, 9th question. If the roots of the equation q minus r of x square, one equation was given, okay? So what is given? That is, if the roots of the equation are equal, then show that p, q, r are in AP. So what is given? If the roots of the given equation, if the roots are equal now, then we have to prove that P, Q, R, R in AP. So what equation is given? Q minus R into X square plus R minus P into X plus P minus Q equal to 0. Q minus R into X square plus R minus P into X plus P minus Q equal to 0. Okay, so here this is your A, B, C, actually AX square plus BX plus C equal to 0. No, so this is your A value, B value, C value. Now, what is given? Since the roots are equal, since the roots of the quadratic equation. Roots of the quadratic equation are equal. What is the condition? B square minus 4ac equal to 0. Now, what is your b value? R minus p. So, R minus p the whole square is minus 4. A value q minus r. C value p minus q equal to 0. Simplifying this and get your final answer. Now, simplifying a minus b the whole square, and if you multiply this two, you will get this one. Again, multiplying with minus 4, you will get this one. Now, this is a formula that a square plus a plus b plus c the whole square format. But here, since it is minus, you have to take it as r plus p minus 2q the whole square. Now, taking square root on both sides, you will get r plus p minus 2q equal to 0. That is 2q equal to r plus p. Q can be taken as 2q can be taken as q plus q equal to r plus p. Taking p to this side, q to that side, you will get q minus p equal to r minus p. Now look at here. We have to prove pqr only ab. No, so this satisfies that condition, that is common difference is equal for pqr. Hence pqr r in ab. Hence solution get over. 10th question. If a comma b comma c are respectively the pth, qth and rth terms of a GB, show that q minus r into log a plus r minus p into log b plus p minus q into log c equal to 0. So here what is given is a b c r p q rth terms of GB, that is a is pth term, b is qth term, c is rth term of a GB. Okay, so first we can take for GP we have to take first term and common ratio, right? So we can take, let a be the first term and r be the common ratio of the given AP GP. What is given? A equal to pth term. So what is formula? A is equal to capital A r power p minus 1. A is a first term and r is a common ratio. Similarly, taking log on both sides. So if you take log on both sides, this will become log A equal to log multiplication. We can take addition. So this you can take log A plus power will come front, p minus 1 of log r. Similarly, b equal to qth term. How can you write that one? B equal to a r power q minus 1. Log, taking log on both sides, log b equal to log a plus q minus 1 of log r. Next, c equal to rth term. What is the formula? C equal to a r power r minus 1. Log on both sides, log c equal to log a plus r minus 1 of log r. Now we can take left hand side of the question. So what is question given? Q minus r into log a plus r minus p into log b plus p minus q into log c. This is given, right? Now log a b c value we found out, that you're going to substitute and simplify. Substituting your log a, log b, log c value, we will get this step. Now q into this one you have to multiply. Similarly, minus r into this two term, r into this two term, minus p into this two term, p into this two term, minus q into this two terms. So if you multiply and taking log a common, you will get q minus r plus r minus p plus p minus q. Similarly, taking log r common, you will get this term. Now see, plus minus will get cancelled, plus minus will get cancelled, plus minus will get cancelled. So you will get log a into 0. Similarly, plus log r, if you multiply this also, all will get cancelled. That is log r into 0. So totally, you will get the answer as 0. That is your right hand side. Hence, it is proved. Next, we are going to see sum of AP, GP and AGP. This formula you have studied in your lower class, right? So that extension only we are going to see. So sum of AP, what is the formula? SN equal to 2A plus N minus 1 of D into N by 2. Sum of GP, SN means sum of N terms. SN equal to A into 1 minus r power n by 1 minus r. Next, sum of AGP, SN equal to A minus A plus n minus 1 of D into r power n divided by 1 minus r plus dr into 1 minus r power n minus 1 by 1 minus r the whole square. So just we are going to apply this formula. Now take your exercise 5.3. First question. Find the sum of first 20 terms of the AP having the sum of first 10 terms as 52 and sum of first 15 terms as 77. So here some conditions are given. Using that condition, we are going to find out sum of first 20 terms. Okay, sum means addition. So addition of first 20 terms. Now we can take, let SN be the sum of first n terms. SN be the sum of first n terms. So what is the formula? Since it is AP, what is the formula? SN equal to n by 2. 2a plus n minus 1 of d. Okay, now it is given that sum of first 10 terms, so S10 equal to 52. That is, if we use a formula, 52 equal to n is 10, so 10 by 2, 2a, 10 minus 1 is 9, so 9d. Okay, that is, if you cancel this one, you'll get 5. So 52 equal to 10a plus 45d. And also it is given that first 15 terms as 77. So yes, 15 equal to 77. Again, same formula, instead of n, we are going to substitute 15. That is 77 equal to 15 by 2. 2a plus 15 minus 1 is 14. So 14d. So 77 equal to 15 by 2. We can take 2 common. So a plus 70. This 2 will get cancelled. 2 will get cancelled. So 77 equal to 15a. 15 into 7 is 105. So 105d. Now we got two equations, right? Now we have to solve the two equations and get your d value. Solve 1 and 2. So what is your first equation? We can multiply first equation into 50. Okay, that is, you will get 780 equal to 150a plus 675d. Similarly, multiply second equation with 10. So what you will get? 770 equal to 150a plus 1050d. Now, so we have to solve this one. So this two will get cancelled. 10 equal to minus 375d. So So D equal to minus 2 by 75. Cancelling 10 and 3, 75. You will get minus 2 by 75. Now, substitute D equal to minus 2 by 75 in equation 1. So what you will get? 52 equal to 10A plus 45 into minus 2 by 75. And again, 52 equal to 10A, 45 and 75 will get cancelled, you will get minus 6 by 5. And taking minus 6 by 5 to that side, you will get 52 plus 6 by 5. Okay, before taking, we have to take LCM. So I can do here 52 equal to taking this to that side. So 52 plus 6 by 5 equal to 10A. Taking LCM, 52 is at 10, 525 to 60 plus 6 whole divided by 5, which is equal to 10A. Again, 10A equal to 266 by 5. So A equal to 133 by 25. Simplifying this. Keep 10 this side, keep A this side, taking 10 to that side, cancelling, you will get 133 by 25. Now we got your A value and D value. We want to find out S20 only now. So S20 equal to A by 2, 2A, 2 into A value by 25 plus 19 into minus 2 by 75. Again, simplify this one, you will get 10. So 10 into 266 by 25 minus 38 by 75. Again, if you simplify, you will get 10 into, taking LCM, 798 minus 35. 798 minus 38 divided by 75. So 10 and 75 will get cancelled. 2 times 1, 5, 5 times. So this will become 2 into 760 by 15. Again, that is equal to 304 by 3. Therefore, S20 equal to 304 by 3. This is your final answer. So we can stop with that. The remaining problem we can see in the next exercise. And your homework is exercise 5.2, fifth and sixth problem. Thank you, students.